6:33, the time right now. Even if you aren't a smoker, you could be exposed to something in your own home that increases your risk of lung cancer.
WOWT's Jordan Shefty joins us live during this Radon Awareness Month. Jordan, good morning.
Dave and Cerise, radon is actually a radioactive gas, and it is the second leading cause of lung cancer. Now, radon is measured by picocuries per liter. 4 picocuries per liter is considered the level where action needs to be taken, and that amount of 4 picocuries per liter is equivalent to 8 cigarettes per day. Now, the EPA estimates that about 21,000 people die from radon-induced lung cancer every single year. But if you need some further examples, I have them for you of just how dangerous this is. If 1,000 people who never smoked were exposed to 2 picocuries per liter over a lifetime, about 4 would get lung cancer, which compares to 6 times the risk of dying from poison. Now, as you increase the level of radon, the risk of cancer also increases. At 4, about 7 people could get lung cancer, which compares to 5 times the risk of dying in a car crash. At 8, 15 people would get cancer. That is 30 times the risk of dying in a fall. 10 picocuries is 200 times the risk of dying in a home fire, and 20 picocuries is 250 times the risk of drowning. Now, how does it enter our bodies? Well, the radon particles attach to dust, and then we breathe it in.
When we breathe those in into our lungs, they shoot off what's called an alpha particle, which is a form of high radiation, and that impacts our lungs and negatively impacts the DNA and within the cells of our lungs, and that's what causes the lung cancer.
Coming up in the next half hour, I'll show you what steps you can take right now to reduce this risk to your family. Reporting live for WOWT 6 News, I'm Jordan Shefty.